hello and welcome to Malmö. You had a very good drive down here, I suppose.
Yes.
It's a nice day today.
Very nice. We should be outside, maybe.
Maybe next time we will.
Yeah.
Well, you're known for fronting many bands, but maybe mostly for fronting Firewind. And a few months ago, you quit the band and fell off the map, and nobody really knows what happened. So this is your chance to give your version of what happened.
It's a long story. No, it's it started with that I felt that many times I couldn't give 100% of myself, and I felt a little bit that I don't want to be a guy that pull the brakes all the time, saying I can't take that gig or do that tour or specific. So I started to think about it. We talked about it many times, and in the end I decided to step down and give my place to somebody else.
But it's been a very long time. You've been with Firewind for 10 years. Was it a long decision that you had to think about for a long time, or was it a specific moment where you felt, now this is it?
Yeah, I felt a little bit that sometimes you can't combine different... I want to do a lot of things, and I also have my family, and you have to make it economically. Mm. It's not easy to play in a rock band.
Yeah.
There are some duties you have to... you have to be there all the time, and like I said, I felt a little bit that I wanna be more free,
yeah,
to prepare something later, do something else. Yeah.
How did the band react when you told them that you were out?
It's not something new. It's it has been a process for a long time. We talked about it, and there was no arguing. It was my own decision. I wish that we had more, you know, like play 300 days in a year, so you can make a living of it,
yeah,
without playing in different bands. Only one band, and you can make it. But how it is today, many people plays in different bands,
yeah,
and it's not easy to combine all that stuff. And sometimes I felt, even if I was there, I had my mind sometimes somewhere else, and so it has to be 100%, 110%.
Did you know that you were going to quit when you did the anniversary shows in Greece in December?
You know, it has, like I said, a process,
right,
for
yeah,
1 year, two
yeah,
years.
Okay.
I almost decided that I was about to leave.
Because I felt
so the guys knew that we didn't talk about it. I think they felt that something's gonna happen, and they were not shocked or whatever.
No. But because you never did like a last show, you never made a big deal, you just went underground somehow and disappeared.
No, you can't say I disappeared, because I still gonna play. I'm still gonna be a huge,
yes,
fan of Firewind.
Yeah, yeah.
And if they need anything, I mean, I'm there for them.
Yeah,
we have always been like brothers,
yeah,
and sisters. No, brothers.
Yeah.
And it has been, I'm happy to have put my part in such a great band like Firewind.
So I hear that you guys are, of course, still friends. There are no hard
of course
feelings or anything.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
In the beginning, you don't... we don't talk so much right now, but after a while we're gonna talk more.
Yeah.
They're busy, I'm busy, you know.
Yeah.
There's no time for sometimes for even chat.
Yeah, exactly. But I mean, do you think that you are in a point in your career where you feel that it's not all about becoming a rock star, that there is a harsh reality also, that there is a very tough business that you have to deal with?
Yeah, it is. I think there are two ways. You can go for doing it 100%, like,
yeah,
full time, and live in a tent or whatever to make it.
Yeah, yeah.
Or you do it like in my case, you just do some several gigs, you do some records, and you don't tour that much.
But you are like still in two bands. So if we take Evil Masquerade to begin with, what's happening with that right now?
Yeah, we recorded a great album, Pentagram. It's fantastic, kind of doom with the rainbow Sabbath elements. I really like Henrik because he's very creative. He has new ideas that nobody else dare to do. He don't go after a manual or he's doing what he's like. With Beggars, it's more, which I like, straightforward. It's rock and roll. Everybody decides together if we're gonna do some tour or gigs. So it's more easy. So it's two different kind of work
there,
or business or whatever you can call it. With Evil Masquerade, Henrik wants to push the band forward and come out more, which is difficult. It's a small band, and Beggars, it's more established since 92, and there are a few people that really loves it, and it's easier for us to make some
touring, some gigs and stuff.
But so it's a struggle for Henrik, and I try to help him as much as I can.
I hope you get more gigs. I really love what you're doing with you.
Yeah,
it's really cool music. Yeah,
he's fighting for making it. He's out on tour with the band Lacrimosa, and it keeps him busy, and it keeps him to find new ways to push Evil Masquerade by doing those shows with Lacrimosa, like I said.
But you, when I look at the musical styles of all these three bands that we mentioned, Firewind, Evil Masquerade, and Spiritual Beggars, are in totally different areas of the rock spectrum.
Yeah.
What is it that makes you decide that, I want to do this band? Because I'm sure that you've been asked by other bands, what is it that makes you feel, I'm going to join this 70s groove band, and then I'm going to join this heavy metal band. And
Firstly, it's good to not to play in bands that has different directions.
Mm.
I don't think it's a good idea to play in Firewind and play in a similar band that plays.
Okay.
I mean, there's no point.
Yeah.
If you want to play in different bands, you have to develop yourself.
Yes,
you have to play in different styles or whatever.
Yeah.
I really love the. The 70s. I always liked the Beggars since 92.
Yeah.
I was always listening to what came out, and it was an honor to go with the band like I did 2009, I think. They asked me.
But since you are a member of, or have been, of many different bands, is it difficult to feel like you belong as a full member in one of these bands? Do you feel like you're just stepping in like a hired gun, or do you actually feel like a member?
Like with Firewind, it was, I think, the only band that I felt that I was a member of a band. At least in the beginning. It was Firewind, because everybody was free to give the ideas to the band and try to do something great with it. Sometimes the ideas was bad, but but many times we, it was perfect.
Yeah.
In Firewind, the other bands are Evil Masquerade is the same, because we already made three albums. They had two before, without me, and after three albums, you feel that you are in a.
Getting
but into it. I think somehow it has to be a band that starting it together.
Yeah.
I mean, put a band together from the beginning. When you step in to new bands, like the last guy.
Yes. Yeah.
It will always be that you are you're not 100% a member of a band.
Yeah, because you haven't made the journey together, you just came in along the way.
Exactly, so. But with Firewind it was kind of, it was like a restart somehow. Yeah. We recorded the album all together, we went to the studio, we did some songs on the studio, like it was before.
Yeah, yeah.
And that made me feel that it was truly...
Your family or your band.
Yes. And,
yeah.
So it was good.
You also just released a video with Spiritual Beggars.
Yes.
What's it about and how does it actually work? Do you say, well, we want to make a video that looks like this, or do you just leave it to somebody else?
No, no, we Mike always, he likes the 70s
style.
Vintage style.
All right.
Even he I mean, he's doing both new stuff and the old stuff. It's good to have different worlds. So we just decided to make it so easy we could do and do the recordings in a rehearsal studio.
Oh, that's what we did.
Yeah,
okay.
And do some parts outside, you know, like the whole band, to show people that we are a band, and we're gonna keep going on with that. So it was, the idea was to make it as simple as possible. Why is this a serpent? Hungry like a wolf. Why is this a serpent? Hungry like a
It is very cool.
Yeah,
it works at least so.
Yeah, and that's all, what it's all about. It's real. You don't have to put some effects, you know, like it's only old effects we use.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
In the 70s with some colors or whatever.
Very psychedelic.
No green screen or no. So
no.
It was straightforward. Yeah.
So, but you're going on tour pretty soon now.
Yeah.
Is it like next week or something
next
like
week,
that?
Yeah.
You're feeling all psyched
Yeah,
for
of course.
It
it's gonna be great.
Yeah. How long is it for? A few weeks, or are you gonna be?
It's only 2 weeks, and when you do only like short package, or 2 weeks, it's very short, and I like it because you can put your energy for those 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Fully. So I think I like it when it's only 2 weeks there and maybe at least 3 weeks. But I don't like more, you know, like 7 weeks tour or
that,
it's too much because somehow a band loses the energy on the way.
Oh really? Okay.
Yeah, I think it's good to have 2-3 weeks.
That's like the
and
ideal
then go back,
time.
Yeah, go back for a month and then you can go
back
out.
Again.
Yeah, I think it's the best thing to do.
So those two bands are keeping you busy, but you're also working as a music teacher.
Yeah.
And does it give you some sort of satisfaction to actually give the legacy of music to very young children and inspire them?
Oh, course. Yeah, I love my work, my job.
I can
very
imagine.
Much.
Yeah.
Yeah. It would be very difficult for me to just leave my job.
Yeah.
It gives a lot of... things.
Something
yeah,
back.
And I'm happy to contribute for students about you know, my experience and how you can work with your music, how you can play or know things and
What ages are the kids that you're teaching?
They are from like around 10 to 16.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
do they know that you're actually touring with bands and stuff also?
Yeah, I try not to talk about it, you know, but kids always find out
they know
stuff all the time,
So it's not like anybody's like a metalhead and thinks that you're the coolest teacher they ever had?
No, I don't think so. Everybody's cool. They think it's cool. It's music. Everybody loves music and that, in that sense, you can say it's cool.
So it keeps you busy.
Yeah, we do. You know, I try to give them how the reality is like do recordings, to play in bands, like I try to put them together, and sometimes it's like in reality that some people don't can't work together, and you can see it.
It's always like that, yeah.
Yeah.
But have you seen any kids that were not interested in it to begin with, but you inspired them to start really digging the whole thing with?
I think I make many students interested.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Many of them, sometimes they, after 2 months, they come up and say, oh, I bought a guitar, or I want to buy a Fender. How much should I put? How much money should I put?
Right.
Yeah. And sometimes even parents wants to play in bands. And it's fantastic. It's fun, it's business, it's everything.
Yeah.
And you can make great contacts, you meet great people.
Influencing on a different level from the beginning, so to speak.
Exactly.
Very cool. So what are your plans for this year, for as long as you know right now? This spiritual beggar's tour?
Yeah.
What else is happening that you know of?
I'm gonna work a little bit with Evil Masquerade,
right.
Of course we're gonna do this is 20th anniversary shows with the Beggars.
Right. Cool.
So that's why we're putting out a new record, and we're gonna do the tour, and we try to do some festivals and some more gigs to late this year.
Oh, cool. Is it any European festivals or?
Yeah, I think we're gonna play in France or I don't remember exactly.
Oh, cool.
We have a schedule. And then when this year is over, I will try to work a little bit with my stuff together with some other people.
I was just gonna ask you about that, if you ever had any ideas of doing something solo. Like, everybody does that these days.
Yeah, I don't want to put it like a solo. I want to, it has to be more like
project.
Work together with other people, not
just
speaking of solo. It's about music, so
yeah.
It doesn't matter if it's solo or whatever.
Okay, yeah.
So I want to work with people that I appreciate, and
do you have somebody in mind already?
No,
or are you gonna start looking?
You know, I have done many songs with Niklas Engelin from In Flames.
Mm-hmm.
We have 50 songs.
Oh my gosh.
That just we can start working if he has the time. We will see what happens after this year.
Yeah.
So when I'm free and I don't have so much to do, because for Beggars it's not gonna be so much since Michael will play with Arch Enemy.
Yes, okay.
So I try to keep it cool this year, and then I'm gonna start to prepare something.
It seems like there's gonna be a lot for you, even though
I left the Firewind.
You left Firewind.
Yeah, it's always.
Yeah. Do you have any message that you want to give to your fans? Like, lastly,
yeah, keep on listening to heavy metal, rock and roll, and thank you for supporting me, and I think we're gonna meet again soon. Rock on.